is run by a bunch of investment bankers.
Morningstar's total self-help.
I'm Jason Stipp for Morningstar. As the markets have experienced some increased volatility over the last few weeks, we've been keeping an eye out for potential opportunities cropping up. One area where we have seen some opportunities is in healthcare. Here with me to talk about what he's seeing in healthcare and how the issues in Europe might be affecting those valuations is Damian Conover. He's a senior stock analyst and the editor of Morningstar's Healthcare Observer newsletter. Thanks for being here, Damian.
Thanks for having me, Jason.
So certainly, I think we've seen recently that a lot of things across the board have been hit by these European concerns. To what extent do you think there's some real fundamental issues with the healthcare stocks that might have gone down in the last few weeks related to Europe, or is just a lot of healthcare going down with everything else that's been going down amid this volatility?
Yeah, it's a great question, and it's an important question. And I think what we're seeing is a lot of the fundamentals for these firms being very, very strong still. So the pressure that's going on in Europe is really causing stock prices to go down where it really is not warranted. You know, for example, Greece by itself is a very, very small market for most healthcare companies. For pharmaceutical firms, it's 1% or less. So very, very small fraction. I think what we're seeing there is potentially fear from investors that what's happening in Greece might spread to other countries.
So, you know, Europe as a market overall, if there is sort of general fear about slowdowns in Europe, about austerity measures in Europe, and maybe government reimbursements perhaps in some of those countries, to what extent, if it really got bad in Europe, might this affect some of the pharmaceutical companies or other healthcare companies that have business there?
Right. In general, European markets are about 30% of healthcare revenues. Certain firms more, certain firms less. Pharmaceutical firms around 30%. So what we've seen in the past is Europe has never been a very good environment for pricing, meaning in the United States, you can have very strong pricing power with drugs. In Europe, you tend to have to face quite a bit of a discount to the U.S. prices. And as these countries are facing problems with their deficits and they're looking to cut costs, I think pharmaceutical firms will have to pay a little bit of that brunt of that cost reduction. So I think that they will be potentially hit, but we have to keep it in context. This has never been a very friendly environment to start with.
Sure. Now, moving a little bit to companies that are based in Europe, healthcare companies, are they likely to have more business then in the European countries? And should we think about them differently, perhaps, than pharmaceutical companies based in the U.S.?
Potentially. I mean, if we take a look at some of the big pharmaceutical firms like Sanofi, we take a look at Novartis, Astra, GlaxoSmithKline, all these firms tend to have a little bit more exposure to the European markets. But in general, they're very well diversified across the globe. So as these companies have pulled back a little bit more than their counterparts of the U.S. pharmaceutical firms, we think that's a pretty good opportunity for a lot of those firms.
Potentially even more of a discount for some of those firms, sort of the Europe discount from the crisis.
Exactly. It's almost as though since they are located there, they should be taken down further because of the fear. But really, that to us seems like a pretty good opportunity.
Okay. Just moving to a more sector or industry specific concerns. Now, healthcare, we've seen some opportunity there for a while, even before a lot of these European issues hit. What do you think are some of the risks still out there from a, you know, absent Europe, but from an industry-specific perspective that you might want to have on your radar?
Yeah, I think the key risk for the pharmaceutical industry is really the patent cliff that most of the firms are approaching and the lack of productivity coming out of the pharmaceutical firms' pipelines. Historically, there's always been patent exposure, but usually the firms have been able to bring out the next generation of drugs. However, in this kind of post-Vioxx world where the FDA is very risk-conservative, it's been very hard for these new products to enter the market. So we think there's a bit of a delay here before the pharmaceutical firms who are just starting to adapt to this more conservative environment will be able to bring out their new products. But eventually we think it will happen, and we think coming out of the patent cliff, these firms are very well positioned for growth, and so we're expecting quite a bit of multiple expansion and some good earnings growth coming out of the patent cliff over the next 2 to 3 years.
Okay, well, Damian, looking down at the stock level then, do you have a couple of ideas where some of these issues might play out and be a good opportunity for investors?
Yeah, absolutely. The two names we like a lot are Abbott and Novartis, and just take those one at a time. Abbott's only is probably the only pharmaceutical firm that we would say consider a true growth company. We see them as growing at double-digit growth over the next 5 years. No other pharmaceutical firm are we projecting that kind of bottom-line growth. And so we think it's really one of the, if you wanted a growth company and you wanted to play the pharmaceutical industry, we would recommend Abbott. shifting to Novartis. Novartis is more of a core holding. We think it's got a great pipeline. Its growth isn't quite as robust as Abbott, but its valuation is much lower. So you got a little bit of a nice value play, a little bit of a growth play, all in all, well-positioned company.
Damian, thanks for the context and for the ideas today.
Great. Thanks a lot, Jason.
For Morningstar, I'm Jason Stipp. Thanks for watching.